Step two, Christ, what to do with doubt. Disguise it as they may, the real cause of doubt and skepticism, in most cases, is the love of sin. The teachings and restrictions of God's word are not welcome to the proud, sin-loving heart, and those who are unwilling to obey its requirements are ready to doubt its authority. In order to arrive at truth, we must have a sincere desire to know the truth and a willingness of heart to obey it. And all who come to this spirit through the study of the Bible will find abundant evidence that it is God's word, and they may gain an understanding of its truth that will make them wise unto salvation. Christ has said, "If any man willeth to do his will, he shall know of the teaching." John 7, verse 17. Instead of questioning and cavilling concerning that which you do not understand, give heed to the light that already shines upon you, and you will receive greater light. By the grace of Christ, perform every duty that has been made plain to your understanding, and you will be enabled to understand and perform those of which you are now in doubt. There is an evidence that is open to all, the most highly educated and the most illiterate, the evidence of experience. God invites us to prove for ourselves the reality of His word, the truth of His promises. He bids us taste and see that the Lord is good. Psalm 34, verse 8. Instead of depending upon the word of another, we ought to taste for ourselves. He declares, "Ask, and ye shall receive." John 16, verse 24. His promises will be fulfilled. They have never failed. They never can fail. And as we draw near to Jesus and rejoice in the fullness of His love, our doubt and darkness will disappear in the light of His presence. Step to Christ, page 111.